Shalom chaverim, here in Jerusalem, all over the world. My name is Itzhak Shapira and I am the host of a program called Yoshvim, meaning able to sit. And today I am actually here sitting in a person that I love so much. I love to visit his home so much, but I love to sit and study Torah with him so much. Ariel Cohen Alloro, how are you doing, Ariel? First of all, Shana Tova.
Shana Tova.
How is your 5777 start? Pretty good?
Yes.
It's exciting. It's exciting because year 5777, I believe, maybe will be the year of the Geula, which means redemption. And you know, last time we have done a program with you, Ariel, and we studied a little bit. We look at the Midot, we call them the Midot, the attribute of Mashiach. We talked a little bit about the connection between Mashiach ben Yosef, Mashiach ben David. But I think we left too many things that need to be uncovered, okay, still. And people need to understand, you know, you have an organization called Facing Each Other, correct?
Yes.
And we are facing each other right now. I am a Messianic Jew. You are an Orthodox Jew. And the only way we can bring the redemption together is by facing each other, not running away, and facing each other and working through things. And I would like to explain to the audience something that you might appears to you that Ariel and I argue about something. It doesn't mean we argue. It's we are discussing it, because it says in Pirkei Avot that any debate for the sake of heavens is worthy to have, yes? So we will have a little duel. But people, first of all, need to understand, you are practicing Orthodox Jew, yes?
Yes.
You believe Yeshua is the Mashiach, yes? Is it fair to say that?
I believe that Yeshua is the soul, is the soul of Mashiach.
Okay.
And it is a reason why we call him Yeshua before his second coming.
Yes.
His second coming, he will be Yeshua.
Okay.
In his first coming, you know, if you do the gematria of Yud Ke Vav Ke plus Miriam, equal Yeshua, not Yeshua.
Interesting. Interesting.
What the Ein represents? The Ein represents the closing. It's a letter of the tribe of Dan. By Sefer
Yetzirah. And interesting, because the
Dryodah don't exist in the New Testament.
But it's interesting because the tribe of Dan, the Midrash teaches, the tribe of Dan was the last tribe in its collecting the treasures that the children of Israel left behind. Do you know that? Have you ever heard this Midrash?
Yes.
So maybe now we are looking for the eye?
The snake have a lot of quality, but Yeshua in his first coming lost the possibility to fulfill his potential.
Ariel, let me ask you a question.
Okay. His letter Ein, that has to do with the mortification of snake, etc.
When you say, got you, understand what you're saying. Okay. Let's take three steps back.
Okay.
Did he lose the Ein? And when people say, well, please understand, when he says he lose the Ein, in my book, you know, that you are reading now, Chazarato Shel HaChazir HaKasher, there was a great rabbi. He was the student, some say he was the rabbi, some say he was the student of Luzzatto, okay?
Yes.
His name was Rabbi Vali. And he says, Rabbi Vali says that there was, that Yeshua, the way he explained it, he say something become a kilkul. But the kilkul, which means something become unkosher almost in him, is not because of him, he says. He said the kilkul happened because there was a sinat chinam. I want to ask you a question.
I tell you why it was a kilkul.
Well, where first of all, do you before you tell me, I want to. That's exactly where I want to talk to you about. Do you believe that there was a kilkul?
The kilkul start with Achaz. It was not a kilkul, any kilkul from Yeshua.
Interesting. And kilkul mean when something became almost unkosher, almost
spoiled.
Like a spoil, unfit, okay?
You know that Ahaz was chosen to receive a prophecy of Yeshayahu about the birth of Emmanuel, and he is the father in this prophecy, and one of his wife, called her Zalma,
yes,
she's the mother of yes. Mashiach, and he's a father, Achaz. Mm. Why Achaz is a father? He's the 26th generation from Avraham Avinu, that equal Yud Kevavke.
Interesting, interesting. Right?
Now, but Achaz was a very bad guy. So
he was a wicked king, yes.
Why he will receive a prophecy like this about the birth of Mashiach?
Yes.
Why him?
Interesting. That's interesting.
It's like one of the most important prophecy about Mashiach. He received it as a king, as yes. a bad king. Why? So really, the worst thing that did Ahaz, that he asked help of Ashur against the 10 tribes.
Yes.
Parkar ben Remaliahu.
And, yeah, and in the north, yeah,
Aram.
Exactly.
So both of them, he was very worried from them, and Yeshayahu told him, don't worry from them, they're finished. And
right.
he didn't listen, and he asked help from Ashur, and for this reason, the kingdom of the north was lost, starting
yes.
in his life and finished in the life of his son, Chizkiyahu.
Yes.
So he caused the loss of the 10 tribes that call the tree of Yosef, mm. that equal Jesus in Gematria.
Wow.
It's Yosef equal Yeshu.
Interesting.
All right, so now, because what happened, now we have to bring a special Mashiach.
What do you mean by that?
What the prophet say about the birth of Emmanuel? He say, we'll eat butter and honey, but for his knowledge, good and evil.
Yes.
It means he will learn Torah. The knowledge, good and evil, is a Torah.
Yes.
Butter, it's like rectification of the good. Honey is like rectification of the bad.
Rega, before you, if could, do you believe, because obviously there's a lot of discussion among people about Yeshayahu. He's talking about Isaiah 7:14 for those of you not following it. And just to give the audience a reference point, you give the story of Remaliahu, you read it all throughout chapter 7, all of the story. Do you believe that's a messianic prophecy?
Of course.
Yes.
About Emmanuel?
Yes.
Of course.
Amazing.
Of course.
Because many says this is not. I agree.
No. It's completely prophecy.
Amazing.
Emmanuel equal kind plus evil.
Wow.
It means the Mashiach contains the two forces. Like Yeshua in his full name.
That's amazing.
Contains the Ein of Esav.
Yes.
And the Yeshu of Yaakov.
Yes.
All right, Yeshu, it's like Yosef that belong to Yaakov, belong to the soul. V'yado chesed ba'kev Esav.
We want to talk about that for a second.
Esav va'yikra shmo Yaakov. Okay, so it's Yeshu.
Amazing.
In Esav, all right? So this Ein, what have to do with the Caesar,
amazing.
Yes, Jesus has to leave it to the Caesar.
Rega. Just one moment. I want to talk about this. First of all, so there is a kilkul today. Let's get back to...
No, I just want to finish something that I...
No, start. I want to talk about this.
Yeah, but with Ahaz, you know, where I was.
Okay.
Because we was lost there completely. The prophecy says that he will eat butter and honey, but
Nahon.
Before he will eat butter and honey, before he will get to the knowledge,
yes, I'm listening.
All the land will be left. It means, and this is the first coming, he will not eat butter and honey.
Interesting.
It means he's above, he's above the Torah.
About the instruction of the second temple, right, Ariel?
Yes.
Yes, yes, I understand. Let's read those verses together. Those of you who follow this, it says, it is in Yeshayahu chapter 7, verse, it says in Hebrew, Lachem, therefore, Iten Adonai Hu Lachem Ot. Ot, first of all, I want to ask you something about the word Ot. Ot is something supernatural. Okay.
Yeah, of course.
So here it does not say betula; it's used the word alma.
In the Targum HaShivim,
yeah,
translate betula alma as betula.
Yeah, yes.
And if you do the Gematria, you know the word alma is mentioned two times in the Torah. equal Miriam.
It's mentioned in the Torah, actually.
In the Rivka. Torah, in the five books,
yeah.
Miriam, sister of Moses, called Alma, and Rivka.
Rivka called
so,
Alma.
Two times Alma equal Miriam, by the way.
All right? Fascinating.
All right, so two times in the Torah is very important. Now, in the Bible, is another two times, together is ten times Chen. All right, so all my work is based on the word Chen. This
but
is
I want to get back to your point. It says, Hera, she conceived, Violetet Ben, she gave a child, Vekarat Shmo, Emmanuel. And then it says, here the what you're talking about, Chema Udvash, Bather and Honey, יוכל לדעת מאוס ברא ובחור בטוב, כי בטרם ידע, before the boy, הנער, before he will know, he will choose the good, okay? תעזב האדמה, the land will be forsaken, אשר אתה קץ מפני שני מלכיה. So what did you say about that? About the land being forsaken?
So in the beginning, you say what will be in the end. In another place it is written that everybody that left in the land will eat butter and honey.
Okay.
It's like everybody will learn Torah in the end of the time. But here, okay. He say something general. He will learn Torah. He will have the knowledge of the difference between good and evil.
So you mentioned...
But before he will learn...
Yes.
Before he get to the Torah... Torah is the tree of fig, by the way, the tree of knowledge, good
okay,
and evil.
Okay.
And the tree of fig was not ready to eat.
Hold on.
If you remember the story,
yes,
you
yes.
want to eat the tree of fig.
Yes.
And the tree of fig, it had to do with the second coming. The tree of fig, that the leaves serve after they seem to cover, it's like the iron of Yeshua.
Are you saying because he rectified... When I'm thinking about the fig,
he didn't eat because the Mashiach represents the Yechidah Shebanefesh, the part of the soul
yeah.
that is above the way that God created man. First man, he gave him Nefesh Chaya.
Yep.
Nishmat Chaim, Nefesh Chaya.
Yes.
It means have the maximum of the soul that you have is what you call the Chaya.
Yeah.
The Chaya is the level of the Torah.
Yep.
But when he go to sin, he didn't have yet the Yechidah. The Yechidah was in standby. In the moment he go to eat the tree of knowledge, good and evil, the Yechidah, what equal Yeshu in order number, Yeshu
okay.
equal Yechidah, with no Zayin, Yeshu. In the moment he go to eat the tree, the Yechidah, the Mashiach, left completely. So he's above the Torah. Yeshua in the first coming is above the Torah. It's why all the Christians are above the Torah.
This
it's why Paul
says,
you are not under the Torah, you are under the end of grace, etc.
Because they are above.
Because Derech Eretz Kadma LeTorah. And now, why?
Derech Eretz, but just let me explain this expression. Derech Eretz Kadma LeTorah is being that manners, integrity, musar is above the law between a man to his brothers are above the ritualistic law. That's what it means.
This what it teach. All right.
So maybe wait. You're now siding with the goyim. So maybe the goyim are right. And there is no need for the Torah.
No, it is written in the end. Everybody will add butter and honey. Everybody in the land.
I
everybody
agree.
Will learn Torah. The goyim too, Malaretz, Deakamaim Lam Yam Hasim. All
Rega. I need everybody to understand something, friends. When Ariel says that, this is very, very important. When he says he called him Yeshua, you might watch it. You say, well, he believes that the Neshama of Yeshua, he's inside, in the internality, it's complete, but it's not went to a full tikkun yet, so we appear as Yeshu. So there need to be a tikkun for the kilkul. So in essence, please understand, he's not saying...
It's not a kilkul.
It's appear like a kilkul, though, Ariel.
It's just not yet. He's above the Torah. It's not a kilkul, like Yitzhak is on top of the tree.
So is he...
Like somebody that sacrificed himself... is above of Torah. If you are in the middle of a
war,
and you jump, you sacrifice your life, you are not going to ask the rabbi if you should do it, you should not, just jump and do
it. Rega. All right? Ariel, so I understand. Is above
Mesirut Nefesh is above the head, is above the...
Mesirut Nefesh. And even when it says, Ani rochev al chamor, yes? You know, he's above
the chomer. The chomer,
it's also from the word chomer. He's above. Yes. He's writing above. They say there's no yetzer hara. You have only yetzer hatov. You're overcoming any yetzer hara.
There's a problem that in the second coming, he came with yetzer hara, with Esav in holiness.
Rega. Okay. But I want to talk about this. This is very, very important. But my question to you today, you're saying he's not mekulkal today? He's not...
He never was mekulkal.
So if he's not mekulkal, then now the million-dollar question comes. How come our people do not receive him?
We get to this.
That's the million.
We get to this.
That's the million-dollar question. If he's not mekulkal, then why do we need a tikkun?
No. We have to understand why God bring for the sin of Achaz, the Mashiach that is above the Torah. For what?
Okay.
Why? Because the sin of Achaz, now we need the Mashiach like this.
No.
We need the Mashiach like this to bring back from the nation the 10 tribe.
Okay.
Because he's above the Torah, so the Jewish, in the Jewish, what counts? Is Caesar, is the Torah.
Do you believe that?
In the Judaism, the most important is here on the ground. If the Mashiach is not going to save the problem with Caesar, it's meant to be him, Caesar,
yes,
to be Mashiach ben David. So this is not the Mashiach we want. So God bring exactly the kind of Mashiach the Jewish don't expect. And it's exactly the kind of Mashiach the nation need.
Okay.
To be a good children, a good child.
Yes.
All right? Now, so it's why Jesus said to his disciple, beside your guys here, I have other sheep that I have to save.
Yeah.
They are not here with you. In the end, it will be one chapter for all the sheep. But right now they are not here. And after he says that I have other sheep that I have to save, he says I have to go. I have to die. Immediately after.
So do you believe he died? I'm trying to understand, make sure I understand. Do you believe he died
to
for
bring
Israel?
The spark of the nation.
So you say he died for the nations. That's what you basically say.
No, for the 10 tribes that was lost in the nation.
Okay, so...
And they come back to Am Israel from Christianity.
So, wait a second. He died 2,000 years ago. The nations have not returned to Israel yet. They're going...
The nations, they don't have to.
Of course. He...
No.
You just say...
Because he came, because he died, because he was crucified, because he was giving away to the nation, we have Christianity. Christianity for the nation, if we talk about a good Christianity with no idolatry, is very good. Nothing wrong with it.
Regal, I disagree with you, Ariel. I flat out...
The Christianity
Regal. Let's look what the Navi...
Nation don't have to perform the 613 commandments.
Regal. I want to challenge what you say.
Yeah.
In Yeshayahu, at the end of the book of Yeshayahu, in Yeshayahu 63, we read the following. I'll just read a few verses. It says, Mize, who is he? Ba mi Edom, chamutz bgadim mi batzera. Ze adur belevusho, tzoe berov kucho. When he called it the day of vengeance. Ki yom nakam belibi ushnat geuliba. Who is the one who is coming from Edom? It's Edom, as you know, Edom is a Sabbath. It's Christianity. it's called a day of vengeance. You're telling me there's nothing wrong with Christianity, but here, according to the scriptures, he's coming out of Edom and he is vengeance. He's demigod of vengeance of Edom.
Any bad prophecy that it is in the Torah, and there are plenty, there are plenty of curse. The curse Yimach Shemo is the name of my book. In all the curse hiding all the blessing in the world, it's just a question of interpretation. Yimach Shemo, you hear this, hear the letter of Mashiach. Yimach equal Chen. My book is based on the word Chen, what is Ark of Noah. Like Jesus said, right, that the second coming will be like.
Ariel, we have to start in the Pshat. We have to look at the very basis of understanding. We cannot go from the sword down.
No, I disagree. All the sin of the first man is that separate the tree of knowledge, good and evil, from the tree of life. All the sin in the world is to separate the knowledge from the life. The knowledge must to be part of the life.
Do you agree here? I was just thinking about it, that the one who is coming out of Edom is Mashiach?
Yes, he's one of them, yeah.
Which Mashiach do you think it is? I'm not putting a trick question. No. I want to drive a point because he made a statement that I think we're going to have to take it in the next program. We got to continue because we have to talk about Geula, okay? We have to talk about the Mashiach. Listen, I just want to read you something that the Ramchal wrote about this, okay? He says, behold, I give you a great secret that is concealed on the word Mizebab Edom. Who is coming from Edom? And he says, Zeh Tzadik, Mashiach ben Yosef. Okay, this says. And he says, and you should know afterward, the Shekhinah, after he does what he does, the Shekhinah will settle in her place. Yachazor Mashiach, he will return. Mashiach ben Yosef, he said, Messiah ben Yosef will return, which, by the way, I want to talk to you about. Veshosho yeh mitchasek alav. And his root will be strengthening, okay? And I want to talk to you about this. Why is he... You said there's nothing wrong with Christianity. But here it says clearly that he's taking an advantage of...
One second.
Ariel, we're going to have to take it in the next program.
It is a lot of wrong in Christianity the way it is.
Okay, I want...
There's nothing wrong in the New Testament if we do what Jesus said. Okay, the Christianity is of what Paulo said, nothing wrong in this Christianity.
If we do completely
opposite.
Rega, Ariel, we have to continue this. Friends, this is now we start to get the business. So this Yoshvim episode, you don't want to miss. So tune in for the next episode as we're learning together. Litraot.